Welcome to Sergei's Chemistry channel. Today I'm going to talk about potassium dichromate and colors which you can get out of its solution. So here that's our end result. You can see beautiful colors, and I'm going to explain how they come about. So first of all, let's look at potassium dichromate 6. Potassium dichromate 6, here is a formula, and here it how it looks. Orange crystals, not very hygroscopic. They wouldn't turn into orange pool of liquid, I think, if you leave them alone. They are moderately soluble, so yes, put them in the beaker, put some distilled water in, and you have orange solution. Well, a bit yellowish if you look at the photo, but I can assure you, if you add some acid, it's becoming orange. Like on this photo. Here, on the right, I added hydrochloric acid to potassium dichromate 6. And on the left, I added to it sodium hydroxide. So you see, potassium dichromate changed into something yellow. What is it? Yellow color is due to ions of chromate 6. Here is the formula, chromate 6. So reaction is reversible. I add acid, I change chromate 6 into dichromate 6. I add alkali, like hydroxide ions, and I change dichromate 6 orange into yellow chromate 6. This is a reversible reaction. You can play with it, adding acid or base as you wish. But essentially, we need acidified solution of potassium dichromate, because that's pretty famous oxidizing agent and we use it in many tests. So here I prepared it, I acidified it with sulfuric acid, and now I'm trying to add some reducing agent to it and see what happens. Let's try ethanol. So I'm adding ethanol here, and you see there is some indistinct dark something on the top. It's where my ethanol went, maybe half cubic centimeter or so. So you see it changes slightly into green, and if I shake it, it's just some indistinct dirtish color. If I add more ethanol though, and help the reaction by heating up the mixture, I would see that color changes nicely into green. Green is due to reduction of chromium 6 in potassium dichromate 6 into chromium 3 ions, which are green in solution, in water solution. If I add a little bit, yeah, you see, look at this nice green color. Also, you see, though they hardly ever talk about it in high school level textbooks, actually, if you hit on the mixture, you get blue color. If I hit it on, and if it's enough of my ethanol reducing agent there, the color changes even into blue. This is due to aqueous chromium 2. I think it's unstable. It would be oxidized back into green by oxygen from the air, but look how beautiful it is. Okay, let's play with some other reducing agents. Here I'm trying to add magnesium powder to my acidified potassium dichromate. Here you see what happened. It bubbles. It bubbles because obviously it reacts with sulfuric acid, which is there in my potassium dichromate 6 mixture. Still, it has enough electrons to reduce hydrogen ions into hydrogen gas, and also to reduce potassium dichromate 6 into chromium 3. So 3 electrons each chromium atom would receive and change into green chromium 3. Here is the green color. It's a green color. It's reduced with magnesium powder into nicely looking green chromium 3. Here now you see, look at these colors. Acidified potassium dichromate on the left, which would be reduced by reducing agents such as primary or secondary alcohol into green color in the middle, or with strong reducing agents such as ethanol or ethanol maybe, into blue solution, which you see chromium 2. Here I put again photos of all four of them. Chromate 6 alkaline solution, dichromate 6, acidic solution, and reduced chromium 2 in water and chromium 3. See you next time, guys. Thank you, remember the colors, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you next time.